As you all know, the world today is going through very complex times. And if you look at the glimpses of the world, at some places we have tsunami, at other places we have drought, smog, and so many other disasters, natural as well as man-made, are playing a great havoc. The population is increasing, and it is expected that by the end of this century, we are going to have 10 billion people living on this planet Earth. And the resources are dwindling, the job opportunities are dwindling, the economy is going down. Earlier in 2000, the economy, the growth rate was roughly 6, and now it has gone down to 2%. The changes that are happening are having very adverse effect on the climate. For example, you can see here the melting glaciers because of the deadly heat, the forest fires, and if you look at the current example of Cape Town, where because of the water scarcity, the people are facing unlimited problems. And all these things can be sorted out if we change the way of life. And that is only possible through flexible manufacturing. It is one means by which we can improve the economy, improve the job opportunities, and also change the environment, or at least arrest the degradation of environment and values in future. 1,130 CEOs in a global study have come to the conclusion that organizations are changing, and there is a drastic change because the entire world is now interconnected. It is acting like a global stock market. Whatever is happening in one corner of the world is having an adverse effect on the other corner of the world. The most important thing is immediately to become agile. So flexible manufacturing has certain tenets: agility and also quality, and then leanness. These, if they are practiced, they can really change the entire world scenario. You can have flexible teams, and then they can work for a particular client organization, and once the job is done, they can be dispersed. And similarly, the leaders of various organizations got together in 2010, and they made a study, and they found out that leadership, organizational ability, flexibility, agility, and innovation, these are the key tenets by following which the world can become a better place. It is not the strongest of the species, it is not the intelligent of the species, but it is the ones who are responsive to the change, those who can make the difference in the world. Agility in manufacturing can be termed as the ability to perform very quickly, nimbly, with leanness, the manufacturing with innovation and excellence without wastage of resources. It provides an ethical and environmental consciousness and responses to the changes. If you look at these two pictures, they give you figuratively the idea of what is agility. On the left side, you have two sumo wrestlers, and they are sluggish, they are heavy, they are applying opposing forces. This is what is conventional manufacturing. On the right, you will see the ballet dancers who are in harmony, who are lean, who are agile. This is what is agile manufacturing, where the manufacturing occurs with cooperation and coordination. Agility is a trait well liked by all, whether it be biological systems, social systems, psychological systems, or manufacturing systems, or consciousness systems. All thrive when there is agility. Now, some of the important aspects of agile manufacturing are, in general, the flexible manufacturing are the concepts of lean, or lean manufacturing, where we want to create precise customer values, goods and services with fewer defects, with less human effort, less capital, less time, and without involving lot many people and unnecessary resources. It removes the waste and consumes just enough resources and does more with less. So with the concepts of lean manufacturing, also the concepts of total quality management are embedded in today's flexible manufacturing, where the first is leadership, the second is employee involvement, And the third is product and process excellence. And the fourth is continuous improvement. When you talk about leadership, the top management should have the vision, and it should have the plans, and it should have the subsequent support for implementing its plans. I'll give you a few examples. Lee Iacocca, who worked as the president of Ford Motor Company in 1980s, had switched over to Chrysler, and then at that time, Chrysler was undergoing through economic crisis, and it was at the verge of bankruptcy. And Lee Iacocca applied the principles of agile manufacturing, formed very lean and very agile and quality conscious teams, and changed everything in Chrysler. For example, he started, though he had to take the federal loan in 1980s, by 1983 he was able to repay the entire loan by bringing in innovation at various levels of the manufacturing process. He created K cars, then he created convertibles, and then minivans, and with the diversity in the product and with agility, he was able to meet the demands of the customers and became, he made actually the Chrysler as one of the top automotive industries of America. Similarly, Kim Woo-chung, though he had a very modest beginning in Korea, he developed an organization which spread across various countries. He had a vision. When he went to Sudan, he saw that there are rich oil reserves, so he said that in future there is going to be a lot of growth here and a lot of cars, and these cars will be requiring tires, and then because the Sudan's climatic conditions are so harsh, the usage of these tires will be very rapid, the degradation will be very rapid, so we ought to have a tire factory here. And he created a tire factory which ultimately proved to be very, very profitable venture. And then he went to Africa. He saw that the people are having a lot of problems because of the lack of infrastructure. And then he created infrastructural facilities there, and that took over. So, and then when he came back to Korea, the government gave him a sinking shipyard, which was bankrupt. And he asked him to help them. And what he did, again he applied the principles of flexible manufacturing, and then he started developing from the shipyard heavy vehicles. And once it became profitable, then he created a big vision of creating a big oil tanker, and he did it, and he sold it to Australia and made that shipyard a wonderful place to work with. Now comes the Indian examples. We have great people like Satish Dhawan, Abdul Kalam, and Sir Anand Swarup Knight, who did wonders at their own level in India. For example, when Indian Space Research Organization contemplated of getting a satellite launch vehicle, Dhawan was the chairman and Kalam was the project in charge. Both worked very hard and they developed SLV. And first time when the SLV was launched, it went into Bay of Bengal. And when this failure occurred, immediately Dhawan came to the press conference and said to everybody, look, it is because of my administrative decision, even though there was a fuel leakage, I asked them to launch this vehicle, and yes, it was launched and it was a failure. I take the full responsibility for this failure. And then he promised, by next year I will deliver you an SLV. And it so happened that Kalam had put in a lot of work to make the words of Dhawan come true. And the next year when SLV-3's launch became a great success, a roaring success which the world applauded, he went to Dhawan and said, sir, please come and join me for the press conference. And Dhawan said, well, Kalam, it was your hard work that fetched this, so please take the credit for that. Face the press. So these are the kind of leaders who are required in flexible manufacturing, who take the responsibility of the failure, and then when the success comes, who share it or who transfer the credit to their colleagues and subordinates. And another example was Sir Anand Swarup Knight, who was a great visionary. In 1917, when this entire place was full of sand dunes and thorny bushes and nothing was there, he contemplated and he gave the vision that we should have a colony, we should have a great educational institute, and we should have a great industry here. And he not only gave the vision, but he worked relentlessly day in, day out, and created a dairy industry. He created the Dalbagh Educational Institute, and he created Model Industries, which started producing at world standard with such quality that their goods were exported everywhere. Normally, people say that we are 99% quality conscious and we are correct. But do you know what is 99% quality? It is 5,000 incorrect surgical operations per week, 200,000 wrong drug prescriptions per year, 2 crash landings at every major airport each day, and 20,000 lost articles of mail per hour. This is what is 99% quality. That is why in flexible manufacturing, now everyone aims at Six Sigma, which is 99.997%. That is 3.4 defects per million. That is the maximum that is allowed in this. So, along with quality, also agility and collaborative manufacturing plays a great role in flexible manufacturing. I'll give you an example of local motors here. In this, it is an open source distributed car company where 3,600 contributors submitted 44,000 designs, and a customer can choose out of these or make a combination of these and give his own ideas of his own vehicle to the local manufacturer or garage, which can build the same vehicle and deliver it to him in few weeks. These are the kinds of manufacturing that are coming up now, where the development cycles are 5 times faster than the traditional manufacturing, and a process which is 100 times less capital intensive. A survey was conducted in the Faculty of Engineering, the Dalbagh Educational Institute, as to the requirements of future flexible manufacturing system. And these are customer-centric policy, agility, economy, sustainability, flexibility, involving basic flexibility, system flexibility, and aggregate flexibility. What we mean by flexibility? Normally, people think when it is flexible manufacturing, it only comes to their mind that there are robots, there are automated guided vehicles, material handling devices, and there are operations using CNC machines, computer numerically controlled machines, and big servers. Yes, that is called machine flexibility, having a workstation. But apart from that, material handling and operational flexibility, you also have volume flexibility, expansion flexibility in today's flexible manufacturing system, where today I am producing 100 cars in my factory per day, tomorrow I should be able to produce 200 cars. Similarly, there is aggregate flexibility, that means depending on the market fluctuations and market demand, I should be able to develop new products, new models very quickly with agility within few weeks. And then total quality management, Kaizen, embedded artificial intelligence, accessibility, and number of byproducts so that nothing is wasted. These are the kind of requirements for future flexible manufacturing. And apart from this, we have zero defects, we have zero inventory, because inventory is very costly. And eco-friendliness, 5 R's, that is reduce, reuse, recycle, reproduce, recover and replace. These are embedded into manufacturing. Collaborative manufacturing, IT-enabled manufacturing, CAD, cloud-based, mobile, IoT, maybe 3D printers, user-friendly, worker-supportive, value-based, community and society-enabled. I'll give you an example of 3D printers. Some of the students who have graduated from this place have started a new company where they were developing 3D printers. They made such technology that on a mobile you can make a design and you can transfer it to the 3D printer anywhere in the world and it will produce that part. So that kind of flexibility is actually developed by them. And now I'll give you another case study of Lava International, an Indian mobile manufacturing company co-founded by Mr. S.N. Rai, an alumnus of Dalbagh Educational Institute with a few thousand crores of turnover every year. This has not only the component of automation, but also it has a lot of flexibility because there are 4 supply chains running in this company with different models. As you can see over there in the pictures, you have touch screen technologies on one side and basic mobile technologies on the other side, and this simple Indian automobile company has lot of supply chain flexibilities. For example, I'll give you one example that is of operational, I mean expansion flexibility. 2.5 years ago, this mobile company was producing 1 million mobiles of various models per month. But now, based on the demand, it is producing 2 million mobiles of different models per month. Apart from this capacity flexibility, it also can tackle short lead cycles or product cycles. Normally, this kind of mobile technology has a lifespan of 6 months. In that, almost 3 months are required for designing the new model and putting it into manufacturing. So there is only a 3 month window for getting the profits. And after 3 months again, the model has to change. So this kind of flexibility is embedded in this mobile factory. Increase in productivity and efficiency through innovation, use of blockchain modeling, benchmarking with external companies, also internally with various supply chains, economy and concepts of waste nothing, and model flexibility on the job floor, that is, once the new model is ready, it only takes 7 seconds for them to change that model. So these are the examples of flexible manufacturing. Along with these, we have some values embedded in flexible manufacturing. They are waste nothing, work is worship, discipline, and economy. In terms of agile manufacturing, these are translated to flexible and lean enterprises doing quality work quickly and economically with discipline, doing more with less. It also encompasses clean technologies and frugal innovations. Flexible manufacturing provides time for you to spend with your children, time for you to spend with your families, to be more relaxed. It improves your quality of life so that you can improve your health, you can meditate, maybe you can get bliss and peace while living in this earth, and also it improves the quality of the entire planet. So the flexible manufacturing also has a component which is called frugal innovation. Here I am giving you two examples, or rather two videos with the example of a sand house developed by UG students of the Albag Educational Institute. They contemplated of making a cost-effective house. So within the available resources, they started taking sand and they filled the sand in the bags and they layered them. And after each layer, they were putting one barbed wire so that there is no translation between the various sandbags, and then they have put reinforced bars, steel bars, so that there is structural stability. And all this they have done within 2 weeks' time to give a model solution, a frugal innovation, which can solve the problems of housing in rural India, where the resources are very, very meager. And they were doing this work with their own hands, cutting the rods, welding them, and then making the trusses and putting them together, doing everything, every piece and every bit of the work themselves. That is basically what is frugal innovation in its reality. And this example also tells us that we live in times of great opportunity and great peril. The significant problems we face cannot be solved at the same level of consciousness that created them, said Einstein. People see things and say, why? I dream of things that never were and say, why not, said Bernard Shaw. In the same lines, education, more education, education made perfect, are the only panacea of our country's ills and evils. Thank you very much.